Why do you use pagination? To avoid fetching data you don't need, while displaying a large table, loading a news feed with infinite scroll, or processing records in batches. And the hope is to avoid putting too much pressure on the database. To do that, using SQL OFFSET and limit seems to be the most common way to implement pagination. And if you try it, it's really simple. We have our news table, we do our query with limit 5, and we get the latest 5 news. If you want to load another page, same query, but with offset 5, and we have the previous news. Unfortunately, there are a couple of problems. Let's try again. Offset 0, we get the latest news. While I'm looking at the table, something happened, and we get 2 more news in the table. Can you guess what will happen when we move to the next page? A query with offset 5 will give back 2 news that we have already seen. Why? Because every time we run the query, the database counts the rows on the current state of the table. The problem here is that the user experience of pages only works if rows will not be added or removed. When a book or newspaper is printed, page 7 will always have the same content, but let's talk about this later. A better alternative is to use KeySet Pagination. Instead of using row numbers, as with offset, KeySet Pagination relies on unique identifiers to determine the starting point for the next set of results. The first query is simple. Give me the last 5 news. For the next page, we know that the last visible news is ID4, so we want the news that are older than ID4. As you may imagine, the query is give me the news older than ID4. In this way, we have a consistent result set view without duplicate keys even when something new is added. Later, we will see how this approach also ensures consistent and efficient performance regardless of the dataset size. At this point, you might be thinking, what if I want to sort on something that is not the ID? Well, it's exactly the same thing, but the query will have to include the correct key set. Let's take a table person with surname, name, and age, and you can sort it as you want. The first query is just an order by and a limit. To get the next page, you have to specify the last seen key. That should include the sort order and the primary key to be able to have the stable result set. To simplify the query, the tuple comparison is really helpful, but it's the same thing as writing the full condition. Depending on the database, you may find a different name, like row values or composite values comparison, but the meaning is the same. The limitation of the KeySet Pagination approach is that you cannot directly navigate to arbitrary pages, because you need the value from the previous page. But it works great when implementing infinite scrolling. You reach the end of the page, and when you hit the load more button or trigger the load more event, you have the last row key available. Since we have seen that the concept of the pages and the page number only works on static dataset, you should consider a different approach on dynamic dataset. The page concept does not really work. User goes on page 5 as a guess, hoping to find there what they need. Mentally, they are doing a sort of binary search with the pages. Probably it's better to give them a search box, a set of filters, or an index. Similarly, you should rethink your endpoints. If you have a page number as a parameter, you don't know what you are loading. It's just a guess. And you may get duplicate items without expecting them. A better approach is probably giving some semantic to the page. For news, for example, you may specify a date. In this case, you know that the page will contain news from that date. For people, you may specify the first letter, a prefix, or a surname. In this case, you know what to expect. If you still want your table with pages, even if it doesn't make any sense in an application with data that can be added, we can try to do some math. Let's say that you have a table with 10 columns, and each column contains 32 bytes. Your page contains 50 rows, and you want 200 pages, which are 10,000 rows. The total size would be 3 megabytes of data, which is probably less than the size of JavaScript dependency you have to draw that table. So you're better off fetching everything than using offset. But if you have large text fields or images embedded into the database, you can fetch only the keys for each row, and then when jumping to the page, you can do a query asking for the specific rows. In this case, you'll get pagination with a consistent view. Now, let's go back to the database internals and see why the KeySet approach is better than using offset. First of all, make sure that you have an index on your order by queries. If your table is small and you have a couple of users, you may not see the problem. But as soon as your table grows or more users are starting using the system, you'll be in a lot of trouble. Sorting requires a lot of memory, disk I/O, and CPU. That multiplied by the number of concurrent users will not be enough to respond in a tolerable amount of time. An index will give you already the sorted rows, minimizing the impact on memory and computation required. Even with an index, one of the major issues with using offset is the performance impact. When using offset, the database engine must iterate over all the skipped rows before returning the requested portion of the data. There are a few tricks that modern databases do to avoid fetching every row, but there is still some extra work to do to be able to get the requested offset. As the offset increases, so does the process time, resulting in slower and slower queries. This performance degradation can become a significant bottleneck, especially when dealing with large datasets. Using the seek method and assuming you have an index, the query will use that to retrieve only the rows that are needed, giving a consistent performance regardless of the data size and the condition. Memory disk usage will also be low, since only what is needed will be fetched. While SQL offset might seem like a simple solution for pagination, it comes with a severe performance, memory, and data integrity issues. As your application and database grow, this problem will become more apparent. KeySet Pagination offers a more efficient and reliable alternative, providing consistent performance, predictable memory usage, and stable data ordering. By adopting KeySet Pagination, we can build applications that are not only performant, but also scalable and reliable in the long run. If you have any questions or want to know more, leave a comment below.